is an initial spark, meaning another form of fire, direct sunlight, or even electricity. So I'm going to create fire over here using a type of fuel from light petroleum powder. It's a fuel, it's a fire powder that forms small of plant mosses, which is a type of plant. And it is a very high in oil content. So when we have the fuel, oxygen in the air, fire will happen right here, right? So let's take a look at one in 3, 2, 1. Is there a fire? Okay, let's do that again, okay? Fire, oxygen, fuel. Is there a fire? Oh no, there's no fire! It could be because the fuel is indirect contact in a dish. So let's change that. Since it's a powder, that means that it is passing out into the air. So let's change the setup. Science is not about cleaning up, so I'm going to try this again. So, fuel, oxygen, I mean warm air, and initial spark. Can I have a thumbs up for everyone? As loud as possible, go fly. Did you see that? Was there fire? There was a fire by the form of a fireball. So indeed, we need a lot of oxygen, a lot of air to create fire. So that was how the laboratorium actually dispersed out into flames. Now, we have fire, but how do we make fire tornado? Right? For fire tornado, we need air. So tornado is a form of a whirlwind. So when we have fire, that's air together. So that is how we need the holes right at the bottom. So these holes are all positioned in a certain angle. So the air from the outside will enter through the holes and right into the center where the fuel and the fire will be. So we